Morning, everybody. How's everybody doing? Everybody's good? It's good to see some of these faces back again. Good. Good to see you, man. Thank you. I'm pretty good. I'm not too bad. I hear we got some questions today. Questions.
Christopher here from Sky Sports News. Our sources have mentioned to us, you know, we've got many of sources, Sky in Italy being our favorite because that's the only sources that we do have. But our sources that we have worldwide have mentioned that Real Madrid are suffering financially. If that is the case and you've walked into a bit of a mess, how do you intend to increase Real Madrid's financial situation and stabilize it at the same time?
Well, I mean, look, I'm a manager, I'm a coach first, you know? I'm not here to balance the books, of course. I will be judged on how I spend my money. But look, we're talking about Real Madrid here, you know? I'm not going to talk too much about the financial situation, but we've got enough, you know? We're good. We're good. Look, if Real Madrid ever hired a manager and he that complained about, you know, the resources that he had, I think that's a little bit of a red flag, you know? Look at the team that I've got. We've got some of the best players in the world, you know? So if I came in here and said that I didn't have the tools needed to do the job, I mean, I wouldn't be in the job in the first place, you know? I think we'd have a lot of worries. But like I said, without going too much into detail, you know, we've got enough. We're good, right? But yeah, I mean, not going out and wasting money is a good way to start, you know? Spending smart. But, you know, I've got everything I need.
Man like Kiro's hand, get me Wolfie and that, Steve reports and that, get me and that in the building and now. You lot tell, hey, listen, shut up. Hey, listen. Big man, where you been? That's my question, you know, forget all the, you know, the football talk, you know, the technicality talk.
This is a football press
conference. Where you been? You get me? Where you been? Because you've been missing. You know, I ain't seen you in the football world for a minute. Where you been?
Listen, I took some time off. FIFA wasn't really talking to me, you know? It hasn't been talking to me for a while. I can assure everybody, FIFA's been talking to me this year. It's been talking to me. If you're a fan of Michael Ramos, you're going to enjoy this one because I come to realize that I've been playing FIFA to record videos, right? And that's not the way to do it. The only reason I would turn on FIFA is to make a video. But now I feel like I'm going to be playing FIFA in order to make videos. And it's a very completely different situation to be in. Because I actually feel an urge to play FIFA and record videos. Just because of the amount of fun I'm having with the game at the moment. But yeah, I just took some time off. I've been here. We've been working on other projects, you know. We've been out here, walkthroughs, all that stuff. So, you know, check it out. But when I tell you I'm back, telling you I'm back. You can see I'm back because my hair, you know, it's gonna be a good year. I tell you that.
Hey, bro, truthfully, I ain't trying to be here, fam.
Who's that? Who's that? I got no hair.
Wolf Sports News is dead anyway, so
that's tough.
Just trying to get this.
Yo, where Wolfie leave, you know, already? You didn't hear what he said?
But anyway, bro, listen. Don't worry about my name, man. Don't worry about my name.
Who is this?
Name are some of the signings, obviously, that you would intend to make, you know, being the head coach at Real Madrid. And that's the best question I've got for you right now, bro. I can't lie to you. You get me, man. I'm done out here if I'm even supposed to be here. You get me, man. All sending me here and that, yeah, for no reason, bro.
Like,
man,
that's tough. To chill out. That's tough. Watch Squid Game, you sound hurt.
Obviously, man, got sent here to do.
You need to follow your passion, my boy.
Sorry. Yeah. What signings you trying to make, bro?
That it. Just like that. That's crazy. All right. Signings. Look, like I said, I'm very satisfied with the team that we have. We have a team full of absolute ballers, right? I'm not worried about signings right now. The initial transfer window is, of course, disabled. If you've been around here, you know that's how we do things. So at least until January, we got to work with what we have. But saying that again, look at what I have at my disposal. Again, if somebody came in here and wasn't satisfied with what they have, that's a red flag. It's a red flag. We got some serious ballers in this team in every position. So Signings, no worried. I'm not working through the door and first thing I think of is signings, you know. We're good. We'll think about that at a later date, you know. Come back to me in January and ask me that and maybe I'll have more to tell you. Anybody else?
Right, mate, it's Jim from TalkSport. Fucking hell, mate. Listen, you've landed yourself in a bit of a pickle, ain't you?
I like TalkSport.
Fucking hell, fuck me. All got your flipping... Benzema's about to leave, you get me? You know, Bale's out the door. Ah, it's all gone wrong, mate. It's all gone wrong. Tell me, because I've been following your channel for a bit. I have. I've seen you. I've studied what you do when you manage a football club.
Okay.
You tend to go after good clubs man. That give you a challenge. Why have you then gone for Real Madrid? That doesn't make any sense, does it? I mean, fucking hell, mate. Like, you could have gone to Real Betis, you know. You could have gone to Getafe. They could do some top-notch managers, and you've decided to go for Real Madrid. I mean, you know, it's not making sense, is it?
Look. It's a great question. I don't know where you get your information from about Benzema leaving and Bale. I haven't even stepped through the door. We got conversations to be had. Look, a challenge. Everybody does know. I do love a challenge. If you guys just give it a second, later on in the video, you're going to see exactly why this is going to be a challenge. Look, I wouldn't have taken the job otherwise. Yeah, everybody knows. Look, I've been wanting this job for a long time. I've been wanting to take over Real Madrid, but I wouldn't have done it if it wasn't a challenge. You already know that. I wouldn't have done it. I left it aside. I've had many opportunities to manage Real Madrid. You know, without saying too much, I've had opportunities to take this job. It wasn't the right time, wasn't the right challenge. Now is the right challenge. I've got things in place to make sure that this is a challenge. We have no room for error at Real Madrid. It's the biggest club in the world. They only want one thing. They want us to win. They want us to win anything and everything. Extend the legacy. Set the standard at all times. You know, when you play for Real Madrid, there's no room to hide. You know, you don't even get to hide behind a color. You're stuck behind a bright white shirt like a damsel in distress out there in the field. There's no room to hide for Real Madrid. This will be a challenge. And again, like I said, you know, you guys stick around and I will explain exactly where that challenge is going to come from. So, you know, I'm ready for the challenge. I'm ready. And this is going to be a long season, many seasons, you know, long save. We got years to look forward to, and the challenge of making Real Madrid a team to truly be feared again, it's going to be something. So if you guys like my career modes, I'm telling you, keep your eyes open for this one. This one is going to be different. It's going to hit different. So, yeah. Is there any more questions? That's all? Okay, I appreciate everybody for coming through. Got a lot of work to do, and, you know... I'll see you guys in the next press conference. Bye. Hey, what's good, ladies and gentlemen? Bitches, welcome back to the channel. We are here recording live from the mothership with a long overdue return to the Career Mode series. The Career Mode King is back. We got a new one. I've been excited to start this one. I've just been waiting to get my hands on next gen so we can have all the next gen greatness. But we are here, Real Madrid career mode. You already know. If you've been around here, welcome back. You know what to expect from my career modes. If you don't, we're going to get into that throughout the course of this video. We ain't going to have no gameplay in this video just yet. But we're going to go over some very important stuff that's going to make this Real Madrid career mode different to any other. It's going to make it a challenge, and it's going to make it the best Real Madrid career mode on YouTube, period. I'm confident of that. I'm back. I'm excited to start this. So let's go ahead. We're using Real Madrid. You know the vibes. Ultimate difficulty. Half length. Don't really matter. I'm going to do that. I'm going to come to a decision another time. We're going to go with Euros. Realism is key around here. That's what I do. European competitions enabled, financial takeover, no. Negotiation strictness is going to be strict. International offers will keep it on. Transfer window, of course, is disabled in a Beninging. Now, before we go ahead and check, go through our squad and whatnot, there are a few things that I want to touch on that we need to talk about that we're going to put in place in order to make this as challenging as possible. That's going to make this a little bit different to a lot of the other career modes that you're going to see, especially with the Real Madrid career modes, because a lot of the Real Madrid career modes that you see, a lot of the career modes you see with teams like Real Madrid, the bigger teams, a lot of people don't really go for realism. So let's go ahead, you know, little unveiling. At this point, you would have already seen my press conference. This is the manager I've gone with. Look a little similar, you know what I'm saying? I didn't spend a lot of time on him, but because I don't really care. Preseason competitions. I was honestly going to start the next episode with preseason, but we're going to jump straight into La Liga. We're already behind. We're going to skip preseason. Money is not an issue. We are Real Madrid. It doesn't matter. Now, a few things I want to mention. And make sure you listen to these, because this is going to be important throughout the series. I know you're wondering, hey, you're using Real Madrid. It's going to be too easy. No. Listen, so we have some gameplay features, or features, and we have some squad features that I'm putting in place to make this as tough as it can be. Now, I've been away from career mode for a while, mainly because I find the game too easy. The game, and honestly, from what I've played this year and what I've seen this year, the game still has a lot of work in order to be really challenging. The AI, they need to be worked on, but it's a lot better this year. I spent a lot of time, I spent my whole 10 hours of EA Play playing only kickoff matches to come up with the perfect sliders and whatnot to actually get myself a challenge. I haven't had this much fun on FIFA in a long time, and I'm so excited to start. But in terms of squad things, so if you go over here, I'm gonna show you real quick. We're gonna go into finances. Now, the La Liga has, it isn't a salary cap per se, but they do have limits. Now, we've seen what's gone on with Messi going to PSG. There's a reason for that, and it's pretty much, it's not a salary cap, but it's pretty much a salary cap to the point where La Liga are limiting the amount of money teams can spend on wages. So we're going to implement something similar to that. If you go, okay, so we can't actually go across right now, but if you go to the overview, I've actually calculated Real Madrid's team wage, and there is a section in the finances that will tell you the weekly wage. Real Madrid's team wage comes up to 4.98 million, I believe. We're going to have a limit of 5 million. Our wage cannot go over 5 million, no matter who we sign. We could spend £500 million on a player. Doesn't matter, as long as the wages don't go over 5 million. So we got to be careful how much we're paying players, how many players we're bringing in. There is going to be a limit. That's number one. Rule number two, squads. La Liga has rules. 25 players have to be registered each season, no more than 25. Players under the age of 23 do not need to be registered. And players have to be numbered between 1 and 25. So any player, if you go through our squad, I think we have about 40 players in the team. Anyone who's not registered to play in the La Liga, we're either going to have to loan them out or we simply cannot play them in the league. That's in the league. We could play them in the Cup, Champions League. League games, we're going to register a squad of 25. Anybody else, like I said, is going to be loaned out if they can't play, or they're only going to have to sit on the bench and only play in cup games. That's rule number two. Rule number three is not necessarily a rule, but it's kind of a rule, but I'm not sticking myself to it relentlessly like the other two. A lot of people believe in the La Liga, players have to have release clauses. That is not actually true. It's just something that they kind of lean towards giving players release clauses because of other contractual type stuff. It's kind of in their favor to give players release clauses. It's kind of in both favors. Whereas in other leagues, it's a complicated thing. But release clauses, we are gonna give every player we sign, every player we resign to a new contract or a new player, we're gonna give them a release clause unless I think that release clause, because in FIFA, you can't actually negotiate release clauses. From what I've seen, at least, and I've played a lot of FIFA career mode all the time. You can't negotiate release clauses. You either propose or disregard one. If you propose a release clause, they'll probably counter. So I might propose an 80 million release clause. They'll come back to me with 40 million, and you can't negotiate that. You could try and negotiate that, but they will never negotiate with you. They will stick to 40 million. So if I'm not going to sign Messi, let's say I sign Messi, I'm not gonna agree to a 20 million release clause. Every player I sign, we're going to propose a release clause. If I don't like it, then I'm not going to have it. But majority of players, we're going to have a release clause in. And of course, I go for realism. So I'm not just going to, if a release clause gets activated, I'm not just going to jump into contract negotiations. Oh, yeah, new contract, stay here. No, if a contract, if a release clause gets activated, we're letting them go, baby. Unless I feel like it's a team that player wouldn't necessarily go to, you know? Like if Bayer Leverkusen activate, Tony Cruz's, well, that would be a bit different because he used to play for Bayer Leverkusen. But you get what I'm saying, you know? Who's a high potential player, Rom Jed? Vinicius, you know? If Norwich activated Vinicius Jr.'s release clause, I'm not going to, you know, might step him. So those are three things. Those are squad related outside of gameplay. Now, gameplay is where it gets interesting. This is where I'm really excited for this career mode. This is something I've dabbled in for a long time. Back in the day, I used to play PES and FIFA on manual assist. Now, I ain't set up my assist yet. Like I said, I just got this new Xbox, so I ain't set nothing up. I don't even know where settings are. Settings right here. So, if you go into, it's actually controller settings. Hey, you don't need to see it right now, but I'm sure you all know what I'm talking about. Pass, all assists. So here's where it gets interesting. All assists are going to be set to manual. Pass assist, cross assist, through ball assist, shot assist. All these assists are going to be set to manual. So it is going to be a challenge because everything I do, I'm going to have to be on top of my A game. I'm going to have to be on the ball 24/7, and I spent the whole 10 hours of EA Play on manual, just getting a hang of it, and I love it. It's so much more rewarding to play the game in this way. I would recommend it to anybody. If you don't play online gameplay, because I mean, you're not gonna go online and play on manual, you're just giving yourself a handicap. But for people who play offline like me, I don't play FIFA online unless it's pro clubs occasionally. If you're an offline player, I advise everybody to try a manual. It's so much more rewarding. You score a 30-yard banger, you did that. There was no assist, you did that. You have to aim exactly where you want the ball. You have to have the right amount of power and everything. But I'm not going to give you a tutorial for manual. I'm sure a lot of you know who it is. Just a little rundown. If you don't, there it is. All the assists are going to be on manual. But the catch is I'm going to have different settings for home games and away games. One of the things that's always got me kind of annoyed on FIFA is that home games and away games, there's no difference. Away games are not more difficult than home games at all. There is no difference. But in this save, it's going to be different. During our home games, the only difference in terms of assists is we're going to have the shot assist on. So pass assist, through ball assist, cross assist, they're still going to be on manual, but shot assist is going to be on assisted, just to give us a little bit of an advantage at the Bernabeu. Okay? Away games, all the assists stand. Everything is on manual for away games. I'm also going to use two separate camera angles. Home games, I'm going to have a set camera angle for the Bernabeu. It's going to make you feel, it's going to make it feel at home, right? This usual camera angle that we always have. It's probably going to be the EA game cam because I haven't used it yet. Like I said, I just got set up on this, but I like the look of it. And then away games, probably the camera angles that I used in my previous career modes. If you haven't seen my other career modes, go and check them out. They're going to give you a great idea of what this is going to be. Like I said, the only way I can put it, I like realistic career modes. I like to have a real, like, my presentation is as if you're watching a real highlight show, almost. That's what I try and go for. But realism, I'm not going to go out and do 5 pre-contract signings in January. I'm not going to do nothing but trade deals and trade Gareth Bale for this dude and, you know, I'm not going to do all of that. I'm not going to go out. Also, another thing is I try and be different. I always try and sign players that are different to everybody else. In my one of the biggest legends on this career, on this channel, is Stevan Jovetic, who I signed in the Leicester career mode. How many people go out and sign Stevan Jovetic? I try and be a little bit different, right? So I'm not going to go out and sign Haaland episode 2. And then sign Jude Bellingham and De Ligt and Maignan and then have all the highest potential. It's boring, right? It's boring. So if you agree with me, if you're that type of viewer and you like to have realistic rumors and stuff like that, even for a Real Madrid one, that's what we're going for. Like I said, realism is not just who you're signing. Oh, you can't sign that guy. He would never go to, you know, because that's a bit different. We are Real Madrid after all. So we are going to be trying to sign some of the best players in the world. But there are more players than Haaland and Dusan Vlahovic. I don't know why everybody and their mum has signed Dusan Vlahovic in their career mode this year. But we ain't going to do that. You know, you're going to have different transfers. You're going to have... Listen, It's going to be the best Real Madrid career mode ever. I'm telling you, I'm confident. I'm ready to go. So without any further ado, that's really where it is. Manual assist is going to be a challenge, man. It's going to be a challenge. The thing is as well, like I said, I've done all my games on kickoff mode in the EA Play. So I didn't even get to play on ultimate difficulty. I was playing on legendary with manual assists and all that. And it was tough. So now I'm up to ultimate. It's going to be difficult. But I'm telling you, Real Madrid manager, I know their expectations. I'm going to get it done. But speaking of expectations, before we check out the squad, let's look at our board expectations. I'm actually a little bit worried. I ain't going to lie, bro. This is the first career mode that I ever do where I'm more worried about gameplay than this stuff, right? Like, what's our domesticus? Of course, they want us to win everything, right? They want us to win everything. And that's what I mean. I'm more worried about these expectations than all the other ones. Because gameplay is going to be tough with these manual assists. But youth development. Sign one player to your youth academy, assigned to defender. Easy. Love it. Sign three players from North America. Easy enough. Well, I don't know exactly what that. Does the youth academy count? I don't know. 15 games with at least one goal scored in home games. See, now that usually would be no problem, but manual assists, it's gonna be hard to score, because hey, like passing and stuff, I've got the hang of that, at least to a bit. Like every now and again, you know, loose passes, not perfect, but shooting, manual shooting is tough. But luckily this is home game, so the shooting assist is gonna be on assisted. But we still gotta build up moves. Like I said, we're still manual passing assist, manual passing through balls crossing. We still got to get into the position to score. So that's a critical objective, both short term. Within 2 seasons, increase your club worth. I don't know how you even... Oh, through player sales and club. That's going to be easy. Always is. And then they want us to win everything as you expect. And those are all critical. So I am a little bit worried. We got... Listen, it's going to be... When you're doing a Real Madrid career mode or a career mode of a team this big, you have to come up with something to make it... a challenge, a real challenge. And I've wanted to do a Real Madrid career mode for a long time. I love Real Madrid. One of my favorite clubs in the world. I just love the sheer size of the club, right? The biggest club in football history. All they do is win. The best players in the world. Like, by far the most Champions League victories in history. I love Real Madrid. I've always wanted to do a Real Madrid career mode, but it's always been too easy. And now, like I said, I've had history playing on manual. I don't know what's taken me so long to play on manual in a career mode. Now is the time. And I think it's the perfect time. I'm excited. So let's go and let's take a look at this squad real quick. Transfer window is disabled for the first season, of course, as you guys see. 25, so we have 42 players. We gotta bring that down to a 25 man squad. Like I said, under 23s do not need to be registered. I don't think there's anything else to point out, but yeah, 25. I don't know how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna have to look through it after this video and figure out what we're gonna do. But this is the full squad. We have Thibaut Courtois, one of the best goalkeepers in the world at the moment. More than happy with him, only 29 years old. We got Diego Altuve. Another goalkeeper, we have Luis Lopez and Andre Lunin, who at 74 overall, I'm pretty happy with that. I haven't looked at any of the ratings in this game, really, so this is my first time seeing them, for the most part. Even when I played, I didn't really pay attention to the ratings. So we have David Quensa out on loan. We have Miguel as a left back, Marcelo and Ferland Mendy. No Nico Gutierrez? He's been playing a lot for Real Madrid recently. So, left back, you know, we got good options all over the pitch. Marcelo is at 80 now. Makes sense, I guess. Marcelo is captain for Real Madrid. I am considering... I'm thinking I want to make Modric my captain and Benzema vice-captain. Well, Benzema's vice-captain already, but... I mean, I don't know. I'm unsure. As of right now, nothing's changing. But we have David Alaba new signing. 84. I feel like that's a little bit low, but... is what it is. Nacho Fernandez, Victor Schuss online. On loan. Jesus Vallejo and Eder Militao. I'm very happy with Eder Militao. I really rate this guy. I don't know how other people feel about him. I really rate Militao. To the point where I could see why they let Varane go without a fight at all. Because this guy in a few years, I think he's gonna be he's a really good defender in my eyes. So I'm happy with him. Jesus Vallejo. Danny Carvajal, 29 years old now, probably injury prone. Injuries is something I'm going to scale up with my sliders, because there's just no injuries in this game ever. So I'm going to put the injury frequency up, so players like Carvajal may get injured a lot more. Might have to keep an eye on that. Alvaro Odriozola is on loan at Fiorentina. Midfield, I don't think there's... is there a better midfield trio in history than Casemiro, Modric and Cruz? I mean, the first one that comes to mind is obviously Iniesta, Xavi and Busquets, but my God. We don't need to worry about midfield right now. We got Casemiro. We got Federico Valverde. Young talent, baller. Toni Kroos, baller. One of my favorite players. I mean, what are those boots, bro? Those ain't the boots he wears in real life, but at least they got some of it right. You know, they got white Adidas. Luka Modric, Eduardo Camavinga. How did he not got a fate? Is that a fate? How is that? That's not Camavinga. That's crazy. He's one of the hottest prospects in the world. I would have thought he... I don't even know if that's a face, but that don't look like him. Anyway, we got Antonio Blanco, Danny Ceballos. Now, I'm going to give everybody a chance. Everybody's going to get their time to prove if they could have a place in the squad. But players like Ceballos, I mean, like I said, we're going to give him a chance. But his time, he's on thin ice almost from day one. Fernando Guerrero out on loan. A lot of these players are younger players, so we don't have to worry about registering them, which is good. Takahiro Nakai, Sergio Arribas. How old is Arribas? 19. Isco. He's another player, kind of like Ceballos, who very stop-start career at Real Madrid, but they're going to get their chance again, as I said. We have Brahim Diaz on loan at AC Milan. Gareth Bale, contract expiring in 12 months. Only 82 overall. Makes sense. Gareth Bale fell off a while ago, to be honest. Takefusa Kubo. Big prospect. Big prospect. On loan right there at Mallorca. Vinicius Jr., of course, biggest prospect at the club, most likely. Eden Hazard, 85. I don't know how I feel about 85, because, like, obviously he's not been great since he joined Real Madrid, but I, like, form is temporary, class is permanent. We know how good Hazard is. Like, we know how good this guy is. So, I don't know how I feel about 85. Rodrigo, another big prospect. Lucas Vasquez, Real Madrid legend. Legend of my Southampton career mode also. A couple years back. We got Marvin at the club. Marco Asensio, probably another one that's going into the bracket with Isco and Danny Ceballos. Again, gonna get a chance, but he's gonna have to improve me when given that chance. I know how good this guy is, so it's mainly injuries that's made his Real Madrid career so stop-start, but you know. Here's what it is. Renier, on loan at Dortmund. Another young prospect. Karim Benzema, in my opinion, possibly the most disrespected player in history of football. Give this man his respect. Give this man... I remember a few years ago talking to my boy Wolfie. Shout out my boy Wolfie from the press conference earlier, like asking the questions. Remember talking to him earlier. I was talking to him about Benzema and Higuain, and there were two players he didn't really rate at the time. And I was telling him, man, wait, I don't know if he didn't rate Higuain. Benzema, he kind of rated, but just didn't rate him that highly. And I remember saying, bro, if Benzema ever got the chance to be the leading man, he would take that chance and do bits. What happened? Real Madrid, Ronaldo leaves. Benzema steps up and he's the best striker in the world right now alongside Lewandowski. Benzema, well, and Haaland. Haaland's a fucking machine. He's a machine. But Benzema... There's never really been a time, in my opinion, where he's got the respect he deserves. Never. Never. The guy is... He's too good. So, Benzema, 33 years old. I believe the highest scoring foreigner in... Is it La Liga history or Real Madrid history? But I'm more than happy to have him up top. Obviously, getting older. Boyan Mayoral on loan at Roma. Again, everybody will get it. Well, I mean, he's on loan, so he ain't going to get a chance until next season, and that chance might be gone, but I like Boyan Mayoral, another player I had at my Southampton career mode. We have Mariano, who I thought was on loan, but he's still here. 27, Dominican Republic International. We have Luka Jovic still. He's only 23? I did not know Luka Jovic was 23. Okay, I thought your time here was coming to an end, but you, okay. Okay, I like you, Luka Jovic. I always have, but I thought he was like 26, 27 at least. Okay, Carbonell and Salazar to follow. So we, again, obviously we have a really strong squad. We are Real Madrid. I mean, if you guys want to take a quick gander at our wage gap, like I said, I've already done the math. And I calculated our wage to 4.8 million total. I'm sure there's somewhere that tells you the weekly wage in the finances. If not, we'll have to keep calculating it as we make transfers and renew contracts and stuff. But, you know, you can go through it. I'll go through it real quick. And maybe there's someone who's watching each episode who's going to do that for me. You would make my life a lot easier if you want to calculate. I said calculate. If you want to calculate that for me, you know, you made my life a lot easier. But right there, if there's someone in the comments, you can do that. I've already done it. So that is it for the Real Madrid career mode. Quick roundup. Wage cap. Squad limit. Release clauses. Manual assist. Completely manual. And different camera angle for away games. Shot assist on. And the same camera angle for home games. That's what's going to make this career mode a real challenge. And I cannot wait to get started. I'm going to bang it out because we're already so far behind everybody else who started when the game released. So, hey, keep your eyes out. Like I said, go and check out some of my other career modes and you'll get a flavor of how we do things around here. But I have some ideas that are coming to this new one that's going to, it's going to level it up. And like I said, bro, I might sound like I'm being overconfident, but I'm very, very confident this is going to be the best Real Madrid career mode on YouTube. Very confident. So, hey, if you're excited for it, this video's a little bit longer than it needed to be, but this is part one. Part two will be coming real soon. And we're going to get started and we're going to jump into it. Like, subscribe, and share. Love each and every one of you. Peace.